Well, hey everybody, it is traveling day. I've got a convention I'm going to. This is back close to where I lived in Tennessee in a place called Lebanon. That's right. When you're from Tennessee, you call this area Lebanon. Even though it's spelled like Lebanon, it's pronounced Lebanon for the locals. We're going to this convention. It's the Music City Multicon. It used to be called the Grand Ole Game Room Expo. Of course, I live now in Virginia, so it's an 8-hour ride, so we'll travel to the place that the convention's at. It's at a new facility. The old facility was in downtown Nashville, and this is outside of Nashville, about probably 30 minutes. So I'm interested to see this place. I've never been to this expo center. I'm also really interested to see how the convention goes because it's supposed to be bigger. But it was canceled last year due to COVID, and now that conventions are back, I don't really know what to expect. So I'm a little nervous. I don't know if anybody's going to show up, but we'll see. I'll show you how it goes. I'll give you the behind the scenes in this video of the whole trip. Also, I know the owner of the convention, and he has shown me some of the CRTs he's brought to the show. So I'm anticipating we're going to at least see, 30. Let's guess 30 different CRTs. I'll give you a good view of them and see what they're using them for. I did bring some really cool stuff. I've got a Sony PVM 1343, the 13-inch one that was the fuse repair CRT. And then I've also got the consumer grade 13-inch Sony Trinitron KV that I'll be bringing. I'm also bringing some cool tools and some other things like a deflection yoke and some boards and a tube and just some other hands-on items so that if anybody comes to the presentation, I'll show them a little bit, but also I'll come up and take a look at them. And that way they can see what the insides of a CRT looks like. And I'll do a little bit of repair talk and things like that. And it's a slightly different presentation than the one I've done before. I did alter it a little bit, update it, and I'll also be checking out some booths. I usually would have a booth where I would sell items, a lot of things I've collected over the years I'd like to sell at this show, but I'm not doing that this year because I'm not going to pack up a trailer and drive all that down there. I'm just taking the stuff for the physical presentation. So the presentation is tomorrow. I'm about to hop in the car right now and go for an 8-hour ride, and then we'll just see if anything interesting happens along the way, and hopefully we'll get there right as about the time the convention is opening and we can hang out and get ready for that presentation tomorrow. Yeah, Brutus, sorry, dude. You don't get to go, man. You get to hang out here and just hold down the fort. So he's kind of mad at me. Yeah, he's mad because I'm leaving him. Sorry, buddy. You'll be okay. Next time you can go. This isn't a dog convention. Well, I've got my coffee. And I've got my gear. There's my little Trini. I don't know if you can see or hear it. But obviously we got a lot of rain on the road today, and that's kind of lame. But I'll check in with you and let you know how the trip goes. That might slow us down a little bit, but still it shouldn't be too bad. Hopefully no bad accidents. But definitely not going to be going as fast as I'd hoped. See a lot of trucks on the road today on 81, but here's something you don't see all the time, a sailboat. Bay of St. Louis, Mississippi. Man, that's a big boat. Oh, goodness. So you got something going on over at the airport today. Look at that. Some type of military craft getting ready to take off. I'll try not to run off the road. Maybe I can get a picture of it. There's a couple of military-grade helicopters there. Airplanes, cargo, something. Interesting. This is a little runway in the middle of nowhere next to a place called Gross Close in rural southern Virginia. Alright folks, I stopped off here, halfway point. It's starting to get cloudy again. Thought I'd show you the gas prices here today. I left my town of Harrisonburg, Virginia. We were paying $3.29 a gallon for that regular unleaded petroleum. And here it is, $3.09.
I'm getting closer, but it's still raining. I just stopped to get some gas.
Found the cheapest gas. $2.95.9.
Here in good old Wilson County. All right, we've arrived, but it's definitely raining here still. But that's the entrance here to the festival. It just started. It's 10 a.m. right now.
All right, I'm here at the loading dock. The car's down there. Thankfully, it's got a roof, and the entrance is right back there in that door to the main ballroom. So I'll go wheel my CRTs and stuff through there, and they'll stay dry so we can get them set up for the show.
Like when you're a big retro gamer gangster here, you get to go in the back entrance and see the madness. You can see the ballroom. It's just gigantic here. The Expo Center, ginormous. Look at that roof. Now those are some big fans. Bigger than the Noctuas. All right, so over here we got a bunch of these party favorites. These are just cruisins, different sit down racing game. I always like to see this one. Might jump on this in a little while. 18 wheeler.
This is a game that's best enjoyed in the arcade. The console ports really never could match this experience. My favorite part was always this oversized steering wheel. It's a lot of fun to spin back and forth. I thought there was also supposed to be a horn, but this one didn't really seem to do anything. Still a lot of fun.
Starting point here for the retro gaming stuff. Let's see what we got here first. Oh, a nice RCA tube with an Atari 7800. And most of these are actually owned by the show's owner and the guy who puts the whole thing on. That's pretty cool. So then next to that is a Magnavox with a ColecoVision, and of course I'd be surprised if anybody really cared about playing that, so that's probably why that's not turned on. Then we got an Emerson. Something's not right with this Emerson. Maybe it's just the fact that it's using a it doesn't look too bad. It looks a little jumpy. Maybe the fact that it's using an RF with Mappy in there. That'd be another 7800. Philips with nothing. And then we got a Sony, our first nice quality Trinitron here, we'll see. And this is interesting. This is one of the real old school machines here, an Odyssey 2. Wow. So, of course, most people look at this and not even know what it is. I know what it is, right? You guys know what it is. Oh, and then we got another Vega right next to that with Saturn hooked up here. Oh yeah, some pretty sweet stuff right there. And look right next to that, I think we got one of these knockoff carts with a bunch of games in it. Oh, here's something worth checking out. So that's a Samsung right there. Next to that we have a Dynex, the off-brand of Dynex. Do not fear, Dynex is here. And we got some Sega Master System right there.
Double Dragon.
So these, a lot of these tubes look pretty darn good. I mean, just for being nothings.
Next to that, Streets of Rage 3.
And a Sonic hack?
Okay, so that's just a hack cartridge on another Trinitron. That's about 20 inches. Most of these seem to be about 20 inches. JVC here, obviously, just JVC. It's got a pretty rough signal going into it. That's composite, so I'm guessing that one's on its way out. A couple of these are turned off. This is a 632X. I was wondering if he brought a 32X on a Sanyo.
And then a Quasar.
The Quasar is out of commission, looks like. A lot of flat screen setups for who cares, right? That's what I say. All right, back to the retro. This was one of my favorites, the Intellivania.
Intellivision 2 console, Intellivania on a Sylvania. All right, I'm not gonna pull any punches. This console was a complete mess. The controllers were absolutely frustrating, insane. I've dealt with ColecoVision controllers, which this was similar to, but there were buttons on the top, on the bottom, a number pad, and a wheel. And I don't know how you're supposed to play a platformer like that, but I felt more like I was using a piece of office equipment with like a telephone attached to it than playing a game. So definitely an interesting experience on this Intellivania.
So that's fun, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. And now we got a Sony, an RCA, True Flat. What is this RCA True Flat?
I've not seen one of these. Interesting. Super Mario World Composite. Let me get back a little bit. Not too bad.
Oh boy. You know nobody's gonna play this unless they're gonna make fun of it. ET, RCA. Ooh, we got here. Look at this Atari. This should be fun. The XE system. Left cartridge. Interesting. Donkey Kong. Okay. Super Famicom. Or just regular Famicom, excuse me. Memorex, CRT, another.
Another one of them.
Late model, no namers. Here's a couple of more old school tubes. I like these old shadow masks. If you're gonna go for it, I say go for the mask that's not flat, especially if it looks good. You've got Duck Hunt here on a Sylvania. I don't know what this is, a Dynamo, a Dynex? I'm sure it's one of those. Got some Tetris on there. Oh yeah, Castlevania, the original on the Magnavox. And then another Magnavox, some more Nintendo. I don't know whether this is a multi-cart or something. And then, that's just the 20-inchers. Then you got the bigger ones over here. So, let's just start from this side. Lovely Philips Magnavox. So this is that sweet spot for consumer CRTs, I think. At 27 inches. I think you go much above this and you get really in trouble most of the time because they're just too big and the convergence and wonkiness at the edges. It's just unreal sometimes on some of those bigger ones. It's just too distracting to me. Here's a Toshiba. Look at this bad boy. The TV, DVD, VCR combination. Ooh, that's actually really sweet. I gotta get the model number off this one. So let's see. Oh my goodness, I can't see it. It's right behind there. Sony Trinitron with
the wow factor.
PC Core Graphics, oh yeah. That's what I got setting up for my show today, is one of those in a demo. All right, so here's a go to Philips with another PC with the, ooh, with the baby back on it. That looks cool. Neo Geo, Magician Lord.
Let's give this Neo Geo AES home console version a try. Now, I own plenty of MVS machines, including an arcade and a MVS consoleized console, but I do not own an AES system, so it's always fun to try these out whenever I see one here at the conference. Lots of fun. Magician Lord is a pretty fun game.
This one's been pretty popular on the JVC. Look at this, JVC's awesome. What a beautiful CRT.
Well, as I said, the Atari Jaguar setup was one of the most popular of the weekend. Of course, it was on this awesome JVC old school television, so I'm not surprised by that. But just the aesthetics of this console, it's really appealing, and I think a lot of people were drawn to that. Now, the controllers were extremely frustrating on this. The D-pad was just a mess on this particular controller.
Here's one I've never seen, True Tech. That's right, folks. Star Fox 64 True Tech. That's a 20-incher, though. Smash going on down here at the Sony Squad. And then you got a nice one of those JVCs again. The Philips. Smashing on the Philips. This is always one of my favorites right here. Tony Hawk.
This Emerson looks pretty cool. I'll admit.
That's got a cool little style to it. Maybe we can get a look at that Toshiba. What does that say? That's a 24 inch. So some of these are 24 inch too. 24. Yeah, we're gonna have to check that one out some more. All right. So yeah, this Emerson looks pretty sweet. I like that form factor. Look at this Fisher.
Anybody ever heard of a Fisher? Look at that logo, bird holding the musical note.
Carrying it off to heaven, which is, I'm sure, what's gonna happen when we see the picture on this Fisher. Come on. What's going on here with the 3DO? Do you have a 3DO malfunction? Did the Fisher die? Oh my gosh, I think the Fisher's dead. It was working just an hour ago. Well, yeah, it cuts on and off. Oh my goodness, Fisher has died. Folks, we have witnessed our first CRT fatality of the show. Let's pause for a moment of silence. Thank you. Sorry, Mr. Fisher. Oh, this is something that, you know, you recently got to see more from our boys in My Life and Gaming on. Super Scope 6, that's pretty sweet. Panasonic. Panasonic representing for Super Nintendo. RCA next to that, with some PS2, some N64 action, Magnavox, oh gosh. Magnavox may also be DOA. Oh, there's another Magnavox. Diddy Kong Racing. Samsung. Now this is the slim Dolby Digital. I get asked a ton of questions about this one. So I've never actually seen this one. What do we got here? Yeah. This one's actually brought in from somebody. So Mark C, I wish you'd come over here and tell me more about your CRT. If you like it. Does it do 480p? I've heard rumors, but I just don't know. All right, here's the JVC D series. This might be the only D series we got here. Lovely D series. And arguably one of the best things to play on the D series would be the N64. Something about those that match to me is near perfection. Especially, you don't even have to go higher than S video most of the time. Mr. Bond on there. I've been looking for some people to challenge me on there, but nobody wants to. And then we have the flat screen experience right next to that. So you got a showdown right here. All right, guys, who's winning? What do you like more? Are you going with the one on the left? Or the one on the right? It's a showdown, Wild West style. Or I guess this would be more European style since it's James Bond. All right, let's finish out here with the last two Sonys. We'll look at, this is a Halo setup. I'm not sure if this is some kind of LAN party. That would be pretty sweet, Halo 2. That's it for this spot of CRTs. There are some more I'm gonna show you back here in the back. All right, guys, here I am. I've made it over to the programming area where the panels are. And let's see what it says over here, room number one. There I am, yours truly, 1:30 p.m. Retro Tech Masterclass. Yeah, so we'll see how that goes. Guess what? That's right. I'm opening for Mr. Billy Mitchell. Whoop. There I am, room one. All right, so since I'm in here and I'm earlier, I'll come in and show you the room. And yeah, my worst nightmares come true because it's either gonna be empty or full, right? All right, so this is the actual room that we'll be doing everything in. You can tell they will be filming, so hopefully I can get a copy from them if that's possible. This was where I will be set up. And then my presentation will be on that lovely drop-down screen coming from there. I love the lights in that projector. That's way up there. Staging here. And then if we look under here, shh, don't tell anybody. But that's where I've stored all my stuff. Look, see my Super Nintendo down there? And then there's my presentation on the laptop, so hopefully nobody sneaks in here. And then, oh yes, here it is. Mr. 1343 MD on the cart, ready and wired up. Under my lovely sweatshirt, I've got the new fan favorite, my very own Sony
KV13, TR28, and then my props down in there.
Again, we're about 2 hours away from the showtime, so let's hope everything goes well. Let's hope some people show up. Let's hope I make it through it without having a nervous breakdown, but thankfully, I think I'll find the confidence to get through it, no matter what happens.
Well, I got my coffee finally. I had to look around the whole place, because apparently coffee's very sought after. And I finally found it back here in the vendor spot, so we're gonna go check out these vendor spots real quick. And just know it's Halloween weekend, so there's a lot of cool cosplay and interesting costumes going on. I'm sure there's gonna be some people in here. We're gonna go through the checkpoint, and then we'll switch over and I'll show you some stuff. You can start with everybody's hero over here. That's right, the man. Sure is tall, isn't he? People are lining up to see the man, the myth, the stuff everywhere. All right, so enough of Big Billy. This is what I thought was really cool. So check out this booth. This is from Champ Games, which is an indie developer. All awesome stuff for the Atari 2600. Now, I've actually come in here before I started filming. I demoed all this when I was looking for my coffee. This is a cool little thing. Check it out. It's got this stuff he's developed hardware here. First, the Atari box, which allows you to get voice sound out of the Atari. And then that's using a controller extender that lets you do quad Atari, so that's pretty cool. Four porter there. Wizard of War arcade, so that's an arcade port over, and it had a really cool stuff where you could hear. Maybe if we get a voice coming out of there, we'll check that out. And then here's another fun one, Super Cobra arcade. And anybody who knows, the original one of this was pretty terrible, by Parker Brothers. But lots of cool CRTs, some cool indie games developed. We'll just run an RF for a lot of these things.
The funny thing was, I replied to me.
Really cool. These are some just really cool arcade ports. And Avalanche. Get some RF technical difficulties on this one. How old school and cool is this TV? Quasar. Conquest of Mars. And this is the one I actually bought, was this Robot War. And it's pretty sweet. It's just like the 5200, where you use two joysticks to control your robot, one to move on the left, one to fire on the right. And I had a lot of fun actually playing it. Of course, this is an awesome controller that I don't own, but maybe we can figure out something. There's just some more information on the game.
And I just bought this. First sale, they said, so that's pretty sweet.
I like to support that kind of stuff. Ladybug arcade. And a Galagon. That's pretty sweet. I mean, look at that. Just taking advantage of new hardware upgrade to the old school 2600s. It's just so awesome. So that's another cool portion here. And let's see what else we can find. Just a lot of stuff for sale. Trick or treating. Some games for sale.
These are, if you're in the front of the building,
five screws. Variants. Atari carts.
Yeah, turn right.
Mario Bros. Lots of cool stuff. Some consoles. Kind of need this. $75. What do you think?
But if you look to the right, you'll see that red trailer. Yeah,
hardware. I don't believe it's a one chip. It does have the extension ports in pretty good shape.
No. Park before is weekend.
Oh, I had to get out of there. I think some people might have skipped on their shower last night. Skylanders. Have you seen Skylanders ever? What do we got over here? Anything cool?
Warhammer 4000. G.I. Joe. That's Wii games. Look at all these Skylanders. Does anybody even give a crap about Skylanders anymore? Seriously. There's a bunch of dumb stuff now. This is some nice Super Paper Mario. $15. That's pretty good.
Really? Yeah, it's hard to find because it's in a box set, so they're not sold individually.
Well, let's continue on and see what's going on here.
I just want to show you how he's got it.
Oh boy.
Interesting. Comics, cards, we got any cool cards? Beetlejuice, Saved by the Bell. All cards, this is some interesting stuff. Star Trek packs. Totally worth, right? All right. More masses of people. Billy and his lady. Oh goodness. All right, well, interesting show. Pretty cool stuff. Lots of cool things. So, we're gonna get out of here now and go get ready for some other convention stuff, you know, some presentations. And then I'll get back with you. We'll see how things go out for our presentation.
Well, folks, we're about 30 minutes away from my presentation. I've got things set up here. I thought I would show you how my whole setup is gonna look for my panel. And I've got, again, a PowerPoint presentation to go along with all these amazing props. And thankfully, I did have time to get everything set up. It was a scramble, but we're good to go. Let's get this show started. I will tell you how it went just in a few seconds. All right, the pressure's over. I made it through my conference, but my goodness, I did get a little sweaty. Can you tell? Perspiration? Yeah, a lot of hard work setting everything up and then getting it all put down in my time slot. Now, it went out pretty well. It is at, I want to say there's probably the max, a little over 20-ish people in the sitting down at the height of it. So let's go around now and see what else is going on at the show. All right, let's go back through the main ballroom here for another look and just to see kind of peak hour here. This is the 3:30 time slot, so we're right in the afternoon. There are a lot more people coming out to play games here today. We've got a VR room over here, so you can probably see some people acting silly with headsets. I don't know. Let's see. Nothing really crazy right now. Some more of the modern games set up over here. PS4 Pro, PS3, Dance Dance, Just Dance 2020. Just Dance still around, right? So yeah. Looks like somebody brought by a Philips. Hello, Mr. Philips, found you. So I don't know, I think I've seen almost 60 CRTs this weekend, maybe more. There's actually some people playing. Always Smash, right? Always loving the Smash. Let's go over here, I wanted to see this one. Look at this JVC. Of course, our Jaguar looks to have froze. This is a cool television. It's an older one. Wolfenstein 3D. Pretty cool. A lot more people here enjoying things now. And the real insane thing has to be the fighting tournament. I mean, look at all the people still here. My buddy Art, he just does an incredible job. I mean, he's back there streaming all this. So that's pretty awesome. And this is a big attraction for
a gaming show like this, just to have all this. So many people here. All right, so we can go ahead now. Let's go through, take a closer look at some of these arcade machines they got in here. Of course, always popular Simpsons. We got here. Bump and Jump, Bally Midway. I don't think I'm familiar with this one. Okay. From Time. Of course, we all know this one, Tekken 3. Sharpshooter. Pac-Man, always somebody playing Pac-Man. Ah, Root Beer, Teppers. I like Tepper. Those cool handles on Tepper. They're cool. That's always fun. Bubbles, huh? I don't think I've ever heard of Bubbles. Sink. I'm gonna have to check out Scrubbing Bubbles. Bionic Commando. The Arcade Experience. Kung Fu Masters. Karate Champ. These are just classic old games. There's tons of stuff here. Track and Field. Play Choice Nintendo. Darkstalkers Capcom. Dude, Battle Zone. But look at this Tubin. Oh my goodness. This might be the coolest game I've ever seen. Tubin? A Race Down a River. Tubin Down a River. That is awesome.
I mean, this game was hilarious. Definitely something I wish I had a partner to play with here at the show, but a lot of fun. You roll down the river on a tube, try to avoid obstacles, and if your raft gets popped, well, then you're pretty much done for.
Tubin Down a River. That is awesome. Pac-Man. This Pac-Man. Space Invaders. Look at how cool the original Space Invaders is. It's got like a reflection on the screen. How in the world is... Oh man, that's just such a cool look. Sports. Double Dragon. Lethal Enforcers. Phoenix. It's just some really cool stuff. Age of the Atom. A Shinobi machine. I like Shinobi machines. Dedicated Shinobi machine. You're a real Shinobi fan if you have Shinobi machine. Time Pilot. It's a pretty cool game. Obviously, you got some screen burn here. Screen burn. Rock and Rope. Golly, what is that? So, fighting, Super Street Fighter. Gauntlet. The original. Literally, Thor. Merlin, Lester. So that's a real old school Gauntlet too, actually. Got some Neo Geos. Four slots. Mortal Kombat 2. Punch Out. Mech Attack, Mechanized Attack. It was working earlier, so I don't know what happened to it. 1943, Commando, Shotgun Ranger Mission, Maximum Force, of course NBA Jam Tournament Edition, and that's pretty much it. Everything else is pinball, so man, that's a quick rundown on all the games. All right, so I've sat here and grubbed up on some barbecue. Kind of taking a minute to breathe and relax. It's been a long, fun-filled weekend so far. Really enjoyed some games and seeing some people. And I mean, look, no matter your opinion on the character and the person, to me, this is kind of a good sight. I mean, compared to what you may think, you know, kids showing Mr. Billy some attention there, the next generation of gamers. So it at least puts a smile on my face, and it's also nice to see, I mean, over 100 CRTs in one spot if you consider how many CRTs are in the arcade machines and everything. Also, lots of stuff still happening, but as far as I'm concerned, I'm done. I will see you guys next time with some more retro content.